Honor Club, where honor is real.
My name is Shane Taylor. I'm the president, CEO, and the captain of Shane Taylor Promotions, and I'm here to make history. Growing up for me, you know, I've made no secret about where I come from, which is the east side of Cleveland, Ohio. Growing up around drugs, guns, violence, gangs, having my house broken into, having my house shot up every other day because my dad and my uncles wanted to fight the drug dealers on the corner. So growing up in that environment, you take a different approach to life. You take a different approach to the way you see the world. You have a different perspective. So wrestling for me was a lifesaver. It allowed me somewhere to be, somewhere to go. It allowed me to have that focus and have a goal. And one of the guys, one of the main reasons that I'm even in Ring of Honor is because of another guy that is from Cleveland as well by the name of Ray Rowe. When I got started in 2007, was trained by Ray, came up together in Cleveland. A lot of the things that we shouldn't have been doing, we were doing together. His path took him to Ring of Honor. I was right there behind him. He was able to get me in front of the right people, and now here I am. Stepping into Ring of Honor, I started off as a tag team with a good friend of mine named Keith Lee. We made a tag team called the Pretty Boy Killers. The reasoning for the name was to be able to show people in professional wrestling that no matter what they thought a star was, you could have guys like ourselves who looked different, who walked different, who talked different, who were different. Things happened the way they did. Keith decided to leave, and that put me in a position where I had to figure out what I had to do next. And my job was to find out how to be a star with or without him. Thankfully, I got brought into the mix with a group called The Rebellion, with Kenny King, Caprice Coleman, and Rhett Titus. The Rebellion was incredible for me. The message that we were sending then is exactly the same one that I'm sending now. And a lot of the success that I have now was directly correlated to my time in The Rebellion. There comes a time when you really have to decide where you're gonna be in history. My legacy is dependent upon me beating Kenny King. I have to get past him. I definitely see Kenny King as a huge influence, not only in my career in Ring of Honor, but in who I am as a person. I sat on the edge of the ring, distraught, because I had given it my all, or at least what I had at the time. And he brought me in for a hug and told me, "You don't know how good you're gonna be yet." And I didn't know what he meant. But then fast forward, I create Shane Taylor Promotions. I go on one of the most dominant World Television Championship runs in the history of this company. And now I know what he meant. I work best by creating a reason to hate my opponent. I need a chip on my shoulder. I need to be pushed to be in a certain mindset to be able to dish out the type of punishment that I'm capable of to beat them. And up until now, I've been unable to do that with Kenny. Kenny's got the speed, he's got the athleticism, he's got the intelligence, the in-ring savvy. I have the power, I have the strength, and nobody knows me better in-ring than Kenny King does. Nobody knows Kenny in-ring better than I do. So in order for me to beat him, I'm gonna have to come with something he's never seen from me before. And the evolution of where I was to where I am, that's gonna be the difference in this fight. Beating Kenny puts me one step closer to my goal, which is the Ring of Honor World Championship. It sends a message to Dragon Lee, and it sends a message to Roosh.